Hello and welcome to my live stream guide for using Logi Capture. Now, when you live stream, you can use a webcam, you can use the one built into your laptop or Chromebook or whatever device you have, but a much better way is to use the Logi Capture device. So I'm going to show you how to do that today. The Logitech webcams are some of the best you can get, and I'm going to show you how to use it today for live streaming. So give your live stream a title. I'm just going to call it test one. I'm going to set it to private because I'm not going to publish this. And I'm going to go down here and I'm going to confirm I'm using USB microphone, this one here, and I'm going to pick Logi Capture. And you'll notice I'm not seeing anything because I need to go and then open Logitech Capture. I've now opened Logitech Capture. So this fools YouTube into thinking it is a webcam device. And it does allow you to do a little bit more and a few better things as well. So you can see I've just got it pointed down at my desk. It's thoroughly boring, but there we are. So I can use two screens, which is really good. So I'm going to use my first screen as well. So I'm using a laptop and I'm using two screens. So here we've got my laptop monitor and YouTube and Logitech Capture are on my second screen. So I'm going to go back here. So we can pull two screens into the live capture, which is great. So I leave it on the preset of streaming, which gives frame rate as the priority. With certain Logitech cameras, you get autofocus. If I put autofocus on, you'll see it's starting to focus on my hand, and it does a good job. It's really quick. Focus on the background, focus on the foreground. The type of videos I do, that's very useful. I can change my image settings. I can make them really bright. I don't know why you'd want to do that. If anything, you're going to make your image lower than default. So if I click reset, everything goes back to the midpoint. I'm more likely to lower things than anything. We can have anti-flicker, turn it on or off. I don't have the lights on at the moment, so it's not going to make any difference. I'm in the UK, so that would be 25 hertz would be the frequency of the lights, so 50 hertz would be the one to pick, and in other countries like America, 60 hertz would be the frequency to pick. If we're using an individual or a product or anything and we've got it against a solid background, we can chroma key to get the background out, and you can pick your green or blue here. I won't be doing that, so I'm just going to turn that off. And in advanced settings, we can do some flipping. And it's quite useful to flip sometimes, although I'm not going to bother today. So something I do is I like to have a banner here, and you can add this here. So you can see it. We've got a text overlay. Here you've got a Logitech watermark, and I think you can only add a Logitech watermark. I don't know why anyone would want that. So I've just got a little lower thirds down here that's quite useful. I don't really bother with this, although I can change my frame rates. I'm going to put it to 30 because I know YouTube is more likely to encode at 30. I can take my sound from a different source, but I'll leave it as default microphone. Here are some keyboard shortcuts, not particularly useful. And I can create a preset if I want to. So I'm just going to minimize this and I'm going to click next, and we're going to go into the live stream of my desk. So YouTube is going to take its thumbnail for the live stream. You'll notice it's backwards. It's been flipped for some reason. I'm not sure why it flips it, because when you view the live stream or the video created after the live stream, it's back the other way. So I don't know why it flips it. Okay, so we've got our thumbnail. And I'm going to go live. So don't forget, I'm going live and it's a private video, so this isn't going out to the world. Okay, so we are live. I can do whatever I need to here. And if I go down to Logitech Capture, I can go to my second display. And now people can see my screen. So that's really quite useful if I'm flicking backwards and forwards between screens and me and products and things. So using Logitech Capture allows you to have two sources, and one of them can be a screen. So it's incredibly useful using Logitech Capture over just a webcam or a camera. And that's about all I've got to say, really. So I hope you found that useful. Do let me know, and thank you and goodbye.